These are plot spoilers for The Scarlet Letter, chapters 1 through 4. Chapter 1 starts with a description of a prison door and a rose bush growing outside it, and that's it. Well, not quite. This chapter is more about establishing the Puritan setting and the tone of the novel, as well as previewing some of its major themes. Look for a symbolic meaning to the image of the prison door and the rose bush. In chapter 2, we meet the main character, Hester Prynne. She is in prison because she committed adultery, as evidenced by the fact that she had a baby without a husband. Hester is brought out of the prison to stand upon the scaffold, a kind of raised stage for public shaming and punishment. She's wearing an A on her chest, A for adultery, but she's sewn it to look all fancy and stiff. While she stands there, she thinks about her childhood home back in England, about the old doctor she married who sent her to the American colonies ahead of him. He never arrived, though, which explains why she's been living in Massachusetts without a husband and why her getting pregnant is such a big deal. Chapter 3. Hester is still standing on the scaffold, her shame on display for everyone to see, when she spots a person in the crowd she recognizes. He's a strange man, crooked-shouldered and oddly dressed. More on him later. Then some reverends, the religious leaders of the community, speak to Hester and demand that she reveal who the father of her child is so he can be punished as well. Hester refuses. A kindly young reverend named Dimmesdale pleads with her to name the guilty party, but still no. After this, they send Hester back into the prison. Chapter 4. A doctor named Roger Chillingworth visits Hester in prison to treat her baby. He's the weird stranger from Chapter 3, and surprise, Hester's missing husband. Turns out he got lost on the way to Massachusetts and was taken in by American Indians, from whom he learned all kinds of mystical medicine and a bit of magic. Old Chillingworth also tries to get Hester to tell him the name of the baby's father, but Hester still refuses. He assures Hester that he has no intent to harm her, but he vows to find out who the father is so he can get revenge against him. In order to do this, he thinks it best to not reveal to the townspeople that he is Hester's husband, and he makes Hester promise not to tell. Hester feels like she's just made a deal with the devil.